In my previous video I created this device. It can make Nintendo Switch to work twice faster with full HD screen. Later I understood that I created almost perfect portable monitor for Nintendo Switch. Almost. Switch OLED does not fit, no space for third-party Joy-Cons, and no speakers. I like games. Xenoblade Chronicles 3 just released. I want to play it in the best possible way, but I cannot take TV everywhere with me. So I just need to create the best portable monitor for Nintendo Switch. This is original Nintendo Switch. This is Nintendo Switch OLED. Nintendo Switch OLED is 2.5mm longer. This slot should be wider. In comments to my previous video, I was asked about third-party Joy-Cons. My previous design was only for original Joy-Cons. As I find out, not all third-party Joy-Cons have battery, so they will work only when they directly attach to the Switch. This or this are okay. They have different shape. Screen. I got this screen from a dead laptop. This does not make it easy to reproduce this build, and it will be great to use some widely available portable monitor for this project. Maybe smaller size, however, mostly available large models or small models. This is 11-inch screen, this is 10, but for a cheaper price you can get an old Dell XPS 12 and a screen controller board. Clever. And I found second screen. This is the second screen, the controller board will be here, and buttons will be on the other side, marking holes. The full model name is here, it is needed for ordering. There are several of them. Here will be a hole for the ribbon cable, soldering power, connecting screen. This part is done. With DC step-up converter, power bank will provide 12 volts to the screen. Choosing power bank was a challenge, not all of them will work. This is a charger from Nintendo Switch, it provides 15 volts and 2.6 ampere. For example, this power bank has quick charge power delivery, it can provide 15 volts, 3 ampere. I can run Nintendo Switch with docking station and this small screen, but it's not enough for this big screen. I had two options, or to use two power banks, one for Nintendo Switch with docking station, second one for the screen, or to find a bigger one. And I found it. You can use Bluetooth headphones, you can use wired headphones, but portable monitor must have decent speakers. This is maximum volume for Nintendo Switch OLED. This is small stereo speakers. Here are another. Inside there are two speakers, an audio amplifier PCB. I will use this PCB, but speakers. JBL sounds better, I will need two of them. In case you don't have some unused speakers with audio amplifier PCB, you can just order audio amplifier board, this or this. Power bank can provide 5 volts for it. And find 4 ohm 3 watt speakers. New design is ready and I'm removing sharp edges. This is how fast it wakes up. Ready to start? I will spend some time in this game. Let's see how long power bank can handle. This is 30% volume. That took 5 hours. Switch is still fully charged. You can continue to play when charging power bank. Connect the dock to the power adapter. This power bank has power path through. It can deliver power while charging via USB-C. And you also can play with dedicated controller as well. This is old one with original Joy-Cons. And this is the new one. I-reinforced Joycons holder. Oh, and I added labels. By the way, third-party Joycons have RGB. I'm not using it. Now I have two portable monitors for Nintendo Switch. I was delaying to finish this video mostly because of the game. I'm already 90 hours in the story. Bye!